So friends, welcome you all in the last session of this lecture series of module number 3. So today we specifically talk about the how to measure a power, especially under the unbalanced load condition or the balanced load condition as far as the three phase supply system is concerned, distribution system or transmission network, or whether you got a three phase circuit is concerned. So invariably we are assuming that your source has a three phase supply, whereas your equivalent, all the load impedances are connected also in three phase manner, and it is very obvious the intermediate media, that is your conductors, okay, your wires, those are used to connect the sources and interconnect the source and load, are also bearing the three phase supply system. Okay, so under the this particular domain, let us initiate our discussion with the measurement of three phase power. Okay, so remember that as far as this topic is concerned, we will be strictly restricted to the measurement of power itself. Particularly, we are going to focus over the three-phase network, okay, considering the three-phase network or supply system. Okay, now you know that as far as the power access is concerned, it can be obviously through a DC circuit or the AC circuit. As far as the DC circuit is concerned, obviously the potential across the node and the current through the load, amount of rated current which is passes through the load, if you will get the product of the two, you will be able to calculate the amount of power consumption. Okay, the power obviously generation can be come from the source, okay, power consumption will come to the load. Okay, theoretically obviously both should be the equal, whereas in practical scenario, if you are going to consider the I square R loss, so that is because of this, obviously the load side, the PL, we can say that the load power, if I will say nomenclature, for our understanding, that is the VL multiplied by IL will be definitely less than that of VS multiplied by IS, product of VS, IS, where the VS, IS designating source voltage and the source current, supply current. Okay. Now, whereas in case of an AC circuit, you know there is an involvement of another role, what will come across the power factor. So, obviously, unlike the in case of DC, where you talk about your mean voltage and mean current. Okay, so in case of a AC, you are typically getting the RMS value of the voltage. You know the fundamentals behind it, and I'm very sure that though you have come across the basic electrical engineering or basic electronics engineering related like subjects, fundamental subjects, so we don't require to discuss here that why the RMS voltage as far as the AC circuits are concerned. So it's the RMS voltage and as the product of RMS current and multiply with the power factor, okay, of the circuit. Okay, as we discussed in the last lecture, that in no circumstances as far as the practical scenarios are concerned, power factor will be reaching to 1 because it has its own disadvantage, right? So the overall you can say, what is the wattmeter in that case? How do we are going to measure? So obviously you know that the instrument is called wattmeter. So it is an instrument which is used to measure the power, okay, in an AC circuit, right? In an AC circuit is called a wattmeter. So remember, okay. So now how many approach we can go ahead? Okay. So see, because in a single phase system you have a single phase, so obviously you are required to dedicate for the one wattmeter. Okay. So in three phase system, though you have a three phases, so the mathematics says that you require 3 wattmeters to measure the power across the all the phases, and then by depending on the interrelationship of the star or delta connection network, we will be able to work out the sum of the 3, right? But the optimization way is that you can use 2 wattmeters. Okay, the combination of 2 wattmeters in a typical ordered fashion to calculate the amount of power as far as the three phase distribution system or the load which is connected through a three phase system are concerned. So you can save 1 wattmeter, so therefore it draws lesser amount of complexity. It Remember, the involving lesser amount of measuring instruments is also guarantee you the saving of the power. So it will also enhance the efficiency of your system, because it doesn't matter how low resistance instrument is. Okay, here we are not talking about the wattmeter in general. It doesn't matter how low resistance equipment is, but the involvement of each and every components guarantees you a bit of additional consumption of the power. Okay, so obviously it reduces the efficiency, right? So as far as the one wattmeter method is concerned, so we are going to see the real power consumptions, okay, with the help of a one wattmeter method. Okay, so let us see in this demonstration what we try to show, that there are the three phase system, and you see there is an interconnection block is here. Okay, so remember, this is the three phase system. So which kind of network it is? So it is a basically star network or Y network, you can say. Okay, so it is a star network. Okay, this is the neutral connections, because neutral is also required to provide the load end also, the intermediate measuring devices also. So it is going to create a common interface point. Now, as far as the grounding is, return to provide a return path, what you can say, right? We remember that neutral is not the grounding, right? So grounding purpose is very different, to provide the safety of the measuring instruments to the measuring instruments and as well as the human personals involving or using any kind of electrical or electronic instruments. Well, the purpose of neutral is to provide the return path to the circuit so that current can, okay, it's complete the cycle, right? Okay. So now you have these three phases, and this is the instrument that is called, which is used to interconnect. So you see, we have interconnected through any one of the phase. So here we will be able to calculate this smaller number of turns are actually typically known as current coil. And remember, this larger number of turns, okay, of conducting path, inductive path, where you have more number of turns is called the potential coil, or in sometimes is also called the pressure coil. Okay, so remember, potential coil is used to measure the voltage, and typically it is connected across. Okay, whereas the current coil is used to measure the current through that particular phase, so it is connected through that particular phase or line. Okay, so obviously in case of instrument where you are measuring the current, the coil which is dedicated to measure the current should have a lesser number of turns, because higher number of turns will generate more number of reluctant leading to loss. Whereas in case of potential coil, you require, okay, larger amount of coil to carry or to hold that much amount of potential. So it is very obvious, you can understand, because it is a potential coil, so then the amount of current penetration will be less. Okay, right. So here the current penetration will be large as compared to the potential coil. Now this is connected through your load end. Okay, so that is, you see that this particular instrument or wattmeter which is used to measure connected through a particular phase. So you will get the real value of current and real value of voltage. That means real value of power. Fine. Okay, but you are not able to get the advantage of the two wattmeter system. Okay, now you see how the two wattmeter system is going to work over here. So as you can see that here it is the same demonstration and is provided here, the same demonstration is provided, a star connected a supply system, and the load is also connected with this, all the three phases related to A, B and C. Now here you see we have connected two wattmeters W1 and W2, where each one of the wattmeter is connected through a particular phase of the line. Okay, so you see that if you through phase A, for an example, we are assuming here that we are connecting our wattmeter which is designated as a W1. Similarly, there is another phase where you are going to connect another wattmeter, let's say that is a W2, and it is connected is number C or B. You can depend in okay, you have your own nomenclature, that is absolutely not an issue, right? Now there is a third phase which is yet left. Okay, and to optimize our performance and to make sure that we are getting the correct value of RMS value of power, okay, so therefore, or the real or instantaneous value of power, in other words, you can say, because instantaneous is actually RMS value, remember. Okay, so we are going to, rather than connecting a third wattmeter, so what arrangement is done here in this method, that the common path, that is the potential coil of both the wattmeter W1 and W2, are finally interlaced at a common point of the next phase, that is the B. Okay, and ultimately all the three phases are connected through the node. Okay, so you see, if this is the arrangement, in that case, as far as this W1 is concerned, what W1 will measure? The amount of current, let's say, penetrating through this particular phase A, okay, through this line A, I will say that, okay, okay, then D, that is, let's say, that we designate over here as IA, fine, okay, let us say that we are going to designate over here as IA, fine. Now, though that the two end terminals, that is the current coil is connected across A and the potential coil is connected across B. So what will happen between these two node points, this and this, it will create a potential difference. And that potential difference is VAB. So ultimately it's a difference of VA minus VB, assuming here that the VA is greater than VB. Okay, at a moment when we measure that particular instantaneous value of or RMS value of voltage, okay, VA and VB. Fine. Again, that is not a matter of debate. Now, similarly, as far as this WC is concerned, this W2 is concerned, which is connected through the phase C. Okay. So in here you see again the current coil is penetrating over here. So let's say I would say that that current is nothing but is IC. Okay. Let's say that is your IC and multiply by the potential. Okay, because this potential coil is over here and this current coil is connected over here. So this point, okay, this will create a potential difference. Okay, these two nodes will create a potential difference and these two value will be how much? It will be equal to VBC. Okay, so let's say we write it VBC. Okay, so this IC multiply by VBC. Okay, so VBC is basically, again here I am assuming that the VC is greater than the VB. Okay, so you can have your own nomenclature. So ultimately the sum of the power across the load you are getting, how much power is being consumed by this particular load, is W1 plus W2. Remember, we are measuring the consumption of the power, power consumption, right? So that's why we are focusing over the load side. So it is IA into VA minus VB within bracket plus IC into VC minus VB. So at this neutral point, okay, where, okay, at this neutral point, you know that as far as if I will interconnect this particular point, that this particular point is establishing the neutral of the circuit. So this particular point should ultimately reach to a particular point, okay, you can, let's say I am fixing over here, okay, through which basically the entire circuitry, or primarily I would say that I am going to remove this and let's say I am fixing a neutral point, okay, over here, like this, as a my leverage we have connected over here. We are then drag it down. We have drag it down somewhere at this point. Okay, you can decide on your own. So at the neutral, you know that IA plus IB plus sum of the current will be zero. So you have a three phase currents, so it will be zero. So therefore, your W1 plus W2, the sum of the two, okay, this particular W1 plus W2, this should be satisfying that particular requirement. So by replacing this, okay, you will be able to get IA, IB and IC contribution of all this. Okay, so accordingly here you can say that this is how you are going to measure the total amount of power. So this justification shows you that you will be able to carry on the measurement of the instantaneous value of measurement of power, okay, that is the power measurement as far as any three phase AC network is concerned across the load with the help of 2 wattmeter methods. Okay, so you can, I will do give you this homework, that you can take an interesting assignment that how you are getting this factor. Okay, I hope that you all are aware with this, but still I would suggest you to do that exercise. Okay, pi is equal to 10 inverse root over 3 within bracket w1 minus w2 and w3. That is the total amount of phase you are getting, remember. Okay, but p is root over 3 of ILVL cos. That is the amount of real power you are getting as far as the measurement of power consumption across the load using 2 watt meter method features network is concerned. So that's all about this. Is a typical circuit diagram drawn by the freehand diagram, you can say. Okay, so here during in this diagram, what I did, that I assume that let's say these three are representing VA, VB and VC with respect to the previous slide of interconnections VC. Let us assume that is the same current IA, IB and IC, that is the neutral, is more proper arrangement of the actually circuitry. So you see this pressure coil is connected over here, terminated over here. So that will complete the cycle of the current. So as far as this is the representation of 1 watt meter method. Okay, this is the exactly the arrangement you need to do. And the bottom one is showing the 2 watt meter method, algebraic sum of the deflection of the sum of the powers using 2 watt meter method. As I told you in the last slide, that lesser number of turns is representing the CC stands for your current coil and PC stands for pressure coil or the potential coil. So that is the interconnections of a measurement of a three phase. Let's see in a proper mathematics way. So if you are going to refer the last circuit using 2 watt meter method, okay. So assuming that the instantaneous voltage appearing across the loads Z1, Z2 and Z3, okay, at a time R, repetitive. Okay, so let's say it is kept on repeating. So that means there is no much fluctuation, or maybe the amount of fluctuation is such a low that we can neglect it. So let's say that is VABVBC. So W1 you are getting across A and C, so that is VAC into I, and W2 is connected through the line B in this last slide, so it is VBC into IB. So VAC is VA minus VC and VBBC is equal to VB minus VC. I'm assuming that C is at the lowest power potential side. So W1 plus W2 is equal to, you will get VAIA plus VBIB two terms, and another you will get minus of VC of IA plus IB. Now IA plus IB is equal to minus IC. So therefore, you will get the sum of the power. So the equation 4 here, you see, it's very, very important. Now as far as this particular demonstration is concerned, so here this W1 plus W2, sum of the power measured by the 2 watt meters, are showing that the 2 watt meter method measures the 3 phase instantaneous power. But remember, though this factor will be kept on changing with respect to fluctuation of VA, VB, VC and IA, IB, IC. So that's why this equation 4 is not representing relevant to the balanced load. Remember, it is an unbalanced load. Okay, so if the load is kept on changing, if the load is, remember, understand this, is a very important concept. So if the load profile is kept on changing, how? Because if you have a house, there are, let's say, or in this particular room, let's say there is a tube light, I would say there is an LED, there is a AC and there is a fan. So there is a not at all a guarantee that all the time I will be kept on using all these 4 resistive elements. Okay, sometimes I may be switched on or off AC, sometimes I may be switched on or off fan, sometimes maybe tube light may not be participating, okay, because I'm not studying, I'm sitting in a just to spend some leisure time. Okay, sometimes maybe LED is enough, more than enough. Sometimes I maybe require the combination of both LED and tube light. So you know that your requirement, power requirement is actually varying. Fine. So therefore, your load profile is also varying. Fine. So if the load is unbalanced in nature, so this equation 4 justifies that 2 watt meter method is a very good method, is very good technique to measure the unbalanced load. Okay, it proportionally reacts you, okay, or responds you to the variation in load profile. Okay, so remember that the sum of the result will be obtained through equation number 4, this one. Okay, so this will be remain same whether you talk about the delta connected loads. If you see the phase current, that is Ia. So now this Ia is lead through the cos of 30. Cos of 30 minus 5. Okay. So the deviation is you are not getting Ia cos 30. So this is the actually amount of power you are getting W1. As far as the W2 is concerned, here you see you will get cos of 30 plus 5. So that is exactly what you can see. Fine. If there is a even a deviation here is say Ia, between Ia and Va the angle is actually now 45 degrees. So what will happen in that case? Okay, any instantaneous value you can measure, that will be the cos 45 minus 5. So therefore the Ib will be fall at cos 45 plus 5. Okay, so that's how the measurement of the balance three phase load has been conducted. And at the end of the day, if you got the W1 and W2, sum of the two will give you the total power, and that we have been already proved. Fine. So I hope this you will be able to understand that how you can measure the balance three phase load and power as far as the power measurement is concerned, and how you can measure the power through unbalanced three phase load. Okay, so the two wattmeter data, okay, so response is by default or naturally giving you the results of unbalanced three phase load. That is which is a very very one of the distinctive advantage of this particular system. Right, let us see that do we in able to position to measure the reactive power using the wattmeters. Okay, so answer is yes. What you need to do, that if you look at this particular demonstration, as here we are going to redraw this curve. Let's say this magnitude is representing Va, and this magnitude is representing Vb, and this magnitude is representing Vc. So Va, Vb, Vc, they all are falling 120 degree apart from one another. Fine. Parallelly, here there is a Ia, Ib, and Ic. The angle difference between phase angle is 5. Okay, between the phase voltage and the phase current. Fine. So therefore, similarly, we can calculate the V minus Vc, and then we can create the Vab and Vbc. Okay, whatever the terminology you wanted to measure. Now, what is the real power? Is Vi cos phi. That is the amount of wattage or what you are getting. What is the reactive power? So you are getting Vi sin phi. That is Var. Fine. Now sin phi is known is that cosine 90 minus phi. So that means if we can add arrangement, okay, if you can arrange a wattmeter in such a way that it will be the current coil carries the current, okay, exactly in the reverse, okay, in the phase difference of the 90 degree of the voltage of the circuit. Fine. So I repeat, if a wattmeter is used to measure the power in such a way that the current coil carries the current and the voltage coil applied to the pressure coil, okay, and this combination is done in such a way that the phase difference from the actual voltage, okay, of the circuit is 90 degree. So if you can retain this phase difference from the actual circuit is 90 degree, as you can see here, okay, that is VL, okay, with respect to the VB. You can see over here, okay, so you can maintain this phase difference is 90 degree. So in that case, the resultant value you are getting Vi cos 90 minus 5, so it is as good as the Vi sin 5. Okay, so this is exactly how the arrangement you have to do. Okay, that is, you see the current coil, this is the pressure coil. Okay, considering the resultant amount or considerable amount the resistance loss, so this phase reversal is connected to your IC. Okay, so you know that here in this case Va is equal to Vb is equal to Vc. Okay, so for example, you are adopting the delta connection. So in that case, the line current will be Ia, Ib is equal to Ic. Fine. So therefore, the VL, okay, VL, Ib, you can see that resultant Ib is here. So VL, Ib cos 90 plus 5, VL, Ib cos 90 plus 5 will be equal to root over 3. Vi, because you know that that has a relation with the three phase relation, it is coming. So you are getting root over of 3 Vi cos 90 plus 5. Now cos 95 plus, you can write it minus of sin 5. So you are getting minus of root over 3 Vi sin 5. As good as you are getting negative of the wattmeter resistance across the load. So what does it mean? That it is measuring the 180 degree phase shift of the power value. So that means now you are actually minus Wr is actually indication that as far as the power measurement is concerned, you are getting the reactive power from the. So that's how you can use the wattmeter also for the measurement of the reactive power by positioning the appropriate connection between the pressure coil and the okay. So there are the some basic problems are given over here. I would suggest you that you just brush up these things one after other. Let's see the first problem. Okay, three non-reactive loads, 5 kilowatt, 3 kilowatt and 2 kilowatts are connected, okay, between the neutral and the RYB phases respectively of a three phase system. Okay, so the line voltage is 400 volt. Okay, so find the current in each of the line conductor and in the neutral. So I hope that you will be able to understand. 5 will be actually 400 volt is given line voltage. So phase voltage will be basically line voltage is root over 3 times of phase voltage. So it is divided by 3. You work it out. So from here you can work out the as good as you can say that the line power resistance is already given with respect to okay. So from here you power, so you will be able to get line voltage is known, power is known, so from there you can get the resistances. So once you know the value of R1, R2, R3, you can calculate IR, IB and IY, okay, and the neutral is equal to IR minus of half of the resultant value. So that's how you can calculate. I hope that you will be able to appreciate it. I approach to the another problem, I would suggest that you solve it. Okay, a star connected load consists of a coil of resistance 2 ohm and the 3 ohm reactance. The load is supplied at the line voltage of 400 volt 50 hertz operating frequency. The total power in the load is measured by the 2 wattmeter method. Calculate the separate reading. Okay, so you attempt this problem. I give you just a couple of minutes. So I hope that you got the answer. You have to calculate both the power across to the individual wattmeter W1 and W2 and the sum of the two, you will get the. So here you see is a very interesting problem that the P amount of power is to be transmitted over a power transmission line, okay, at a line to line voltage V and the power factor cos theta. So that is given to you. This power may be transmitted by a single phase two wire line or by a three phase three wire line. The choice depending upon which line requires the least copper loss, which line required the least copper loss. Remember the copper loss you are connecting when the circuit is actually closed, is connected in the load. Okay, yes, in other words you can say that it is short circuited, right? So which system will be chosen and what is the approximate saving in the copper? Okay, so to do that, to get the approximate saving in the copper, you have to find the volumetric area. And before that, you have to probably interrelate the resistance between the both the lines. Okay, and for that, you have to equate the power equations. Okay, that's a very interesting problem. You solved it. You attempted, I guess. So I hope that you got your answer. Okay, so you can very well see in the next slide. So here, as you can see, that in my assumptions I have considered that I1 is representing that is the single phase line current and the I3 is the three phase line current, so that you can get the amount of power because of the single phase line current and the three phase line current, and then both you should equate so that you will be able to conclude, okay, that I mean which case that the copper loss will be less, fine, considering the amount of line, fine. So if you compare that, you will be able to calculate the power loss. So therefore you have to come up the power loss of both the single phase and three phase system. So if you are comparing that, you will obviously get the equivalent relation between the resistances used in the amount of resistance in the experience in the three phase line with respect to the single phase line. And you know R is equal to rho into L by a standard equation, where rho is the resistivity of the material, that is the constant. So you replace it by L by A. So from there you will be able to get the volume of the. Okay, so I hope that it's a very interesting problem. You got a very important lesson from it. Thank you. Interesting problem. Okay. So along with that, I also given you some couple of tutorial problems also. So well, still, if you have any doubts, that don't hesitate to revert back to me. And with this, we are going to conclude the module number 3. So as far as the module number next module is concerned, so on series. The next module as per the syllabus is the network synthesis. So, but I would insist that sometimes being an maintain the continuity, we can discuss the module number 4 as of its own placed location, or we can consider it at the later the stage, and we can finish up the graphical method of network analysis, that is the graph theory, and followed by the brief introduction to the special class of the network circuit, that is called the filters. Okay, and then we can come back to the synthesis and finish up the titles. Okay, so in the next lecture we will be meeting with the remaining content, that is the network synthesis and the graph theory or the graphical approach of network analysis along with the filter design. Okay, with this, thank you.